JBTV is brought to you by GuitarCable.com.
Stand by, roll tape, market, action. Hey, I'm Jerry Bryant. Welcome to the brand new edition of JBTV. You know, we're broadcasting from the center of the musical universe, downtown Chicago. And in the studio, I have Chicago's own Sons as they perform live right here at JBTV. And then Tanner has Cameron McGill and What Army as they perform live on our JBTV High Definition Soundstage. Jarrod Gorbel is at the House of Blues with Jenna Martinelli. A great, great interview. Plus, Toby's right here at JBTV with the Get Up Kids. The year is 1993. It is the first performance in Chicago of 311, and JBTV was there. Are you ready? Non-stop style. Stand by. The show starts right now. Ha ha, action. Welcome to the brand new edition of JBTV, your alternative show from downtown Chicago. Now our 26th year of great music. And on our 26th year, we have the Sons in the studio.
By far, coolest boss ever.
What made you get a bus for your bus? You know, bigger's better.
Talking good one, but you never sound right on. You're talking good one, but you never sound right on.
Deep down, deep down, deep down.
we have the Sons in the studio, and they are an amazing, amazing band. And what really is amazing about them is they have two drummers. So how did this happen?
But the two drummers came about because when we just started writing songs, we had all these kind of powerful songs, and when we had just Chris, not that he didn't cut it, but we were like, and then so we tested a whole bunch of people, or tried a bunch of people out. We couldn't really figure it out and get it to sound how we wanted to in our heads, you know. And then finally Clint came, and you know, we wrote all these syncopated drum parts and stuff, and from there
it just gives such a big sound, you know.
Well, and that's what we were kind of going for, but then, you know, we couldn't get that out of one drummer. We just couldn't.
So what happens if you get like four drummers on stage?
Then we wouldn't be allowed to play anymore.
Up next on JBTV, Cameron McGill and What Army. Plus, Toby is in the studio with the Get Up Kids. It's all here on JBTV.
Hey, we're Fake Problems, and you're watching JBTV.
Hello guys, my name is Tanner Rittenhouse for JBTV, and I'm here with Cameron McGill and What Army. What's going on, guys?
How you doing?
Doing awesome.
Doing all right. What do you guys think of the studio so far? Not too bad. I've seen better.
Yeah.
Googled you, and there's a weird story about you from like growing up on like the Black Forest in 1877. And what is that about? What did you do?
Oh, well, that's a Bertolt Brecht's bio. Just stole it from him.
Good job. Maybe we won't put that out there. We'll keep your secret safe.
He's gone.
There we go.
He's passed into the next realm. So yeah, I don't think it'll be a problem. But yeah, I found out in the back of one of his poetry books, and then decided that was going to be better than basically any bio that I would try to write. Some band bios are pretty difficult to get through.
It's almost like an art form. To write a really bad one, number one, and to even write a good one, it's a little,
the truth.
That's
the other part of the truth.
Is kind of boring. This is America.
I think next time if you guys ever like reamp it, you should just get Total Recall and just like the screenplay and put that under there.
Yeah.
If you want any more interesting, if you want a really interesting story.
Incredible life. You know what I mean? That was just like, you know, living in Europe, World War I, and he went crazy, and he was in a sanatorium. Got time.
Non-stop music with Chicago's own Sons performing live, and Toby's in the studio with Get Up Kids. Keep it tuned right here.
Hi, this is Fat Mike. I play in NoFX and Me First in the Gimme Gimmies, and sometimes I put on clown makeup and play with myself. You're watching JBTV.
JBTV!
I'm here, Toby Jagg, with Kansas City's Get Up Kids. Not a lot of bands come out of Kansas City, huh?
No, not so much.
No, it's not really a mecca of rock and roll.
That made it probably easy for you guys to break out of there. Punk, dude. Yeah, do one of these. Do this. Yeah. Just do it. Come on. So you guys formed like in the mid-90s probably, the Get Up Kids?
1995.
Our senior year of high school.
Take us back to like when that scene was kind of awesome and unique. And like, what kind of bands inspired you guys to do what you're doing?
Captain Jazz,
sure.
A lot of Christy Front Drive.
You guys had a big breakthrough when you signed to Vagrant Records. And you guys go on to tour with bands like Green Day and Weezer. Mm-hmm. Kind of a big deal, you know?
Yeah.
Must have been kind of cool, you guys coming from, you know, from the barbecue pits to the arenas, you
know? From the basement scene, basement circuit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We played a lot of basements.
Things kind of start winding down around 2006, maybe?
You know, you're in a van or in a bus for 9 years straight or whatever. You kind of start to lose track of what real life is like.
Yeah, and then you guys, the band kind of goes on hiatus or disbands for how long, like 4 years or something?
Yeah, 4 or 5 years. Yeah. And then we started playing shows again in 2009.
Well, now you're back, and what's your record called?
It's called There Are Rules.
Okay, There Are Rules, and I'm sure we're going to play your video from There Are Rules.
You should.
It's good.
Yeah.
It's called Automatic, I believe.
Uh-huh.
And what we're going to do with the like technology is going to make it so we are going to splice in shots of this video with this interview.
Whoa.
It's going to be awesome.
Wow.
It's going to look pretty good.
It's like
good.
A professional operation.
Well, look at the graphics around you. It's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Have you tried some of our snacks here at JBTV?
Not
we got
yet.
Snacks.
Well,
look at Jerry. Wow, you look like Santa Claus, and you also bring gifts. Would you like to say anything to Pop Chips?
Thank you, Pop Chips.
Thanks for hanging out with us here on JBTV. Do it. Come on. I know you won't do the Mohawk, but you give me a high five, won't you? All right. Cool. Well, cheers, y'all.
Hi, I'm Jim.
And I'm Rob from the Get Up Kids, and this is JBTV.
You had another band ages ago.
Wax on Radio.
Yeah. Now, what's happened? Is that done with now, or?
I mean, I still play with Bob a lot. You know, we were in a side project band called Hole and Crow that CJ is in also, but, you know, that band had run its course for a while by the time we were finally like, we can't do anything else. You know? We had so many problems by the end of the year, you know, call it quits. But, you know, we're still all friends. And stuff, so.
Yeah, but now you created your new thing, so yeah. Give us the beginnings about that. With Sons.
With Sons, yeah. I mean, I was pretty bummed out after Wax had broke up, and you know, Cody kept poking me to. I live with Cody. Well, I do not. I have them too. And he kept poking me to play music and stuff, and I was just kind of like, yeah, you know, I'll go to Whirl, whatever. And then finally, he brought Nick down because he was like, I know this really great guitar player, you know. And so, and for me, it was like, if I can't be in a band with Bob, like, oh man, it's such a bummer, you know. So we started playing some music together, me and Nick, and I was like, it's so crazy it could work. And then, you know, from there, we just, Cody kind of just brought everybody in one by one. Well, I guess Nick knew Chris, and that was the second person. And then Cody brought Lemke in, and Lemke brought Clint in. So Cody's like the hub of our band, yeah.
Whenever we do interviews, it's always, they call me the hub. That's
the
how
hub?
We, yeah.
Is that like the grub hub?
Probably just as good.
Still to come on JBTV, Sons performing live, and later, Jarrod Gorbel's at the House of Blues with Jenna. It's all here next.
We're Minus the Bear, and you're watching JBTV.
JBTV!
Problem with this band, and it's been awesome, thank you, has been like, you know, the amount of gear that which we never took into consideration while writing the song. We're just like, oh, I'll play mandolin in this one. Oh, let's have this big, huge Fender Rhodes, and we'll just carry that around or something. And so, you know, when we started to play shows, we were just like, we need something to travel in. So we bought this big, huge trailer that we all fit in. And,
It's airy. It's nice and roomy.
Yeah. Well, I mean, things went swimmingly. We went down to South by Southwest and back, and everything was great. And then one day, we're about to start practicing. Lucky comes, and this guy messes with people all the time. He does wild stuff. He's a crazy guy. So, like, he comes down the stairs. He's like, the trailer's on fire. Everybody needs to go outside right now. And we're like, yeah, okay. And we're, like, still, like, messing
another
around.
Another crazy joke.
And then somebody's
screwing
like,
around.
Yeah. Somebody's like, I smell smoke. And so he,
yeah. Everybody's just stopped. And just put down everything that they were doing, ran up the stairs and just like walked out to like this inferno. And like the first thing that happens is Mike runs and grabs a hose, like a little garden hose, and he's just like, there's a great picture of that too, where he's just got the hose, he's kind of doing this, and the fire is just going crazy, he's trying to put it out with a little garden hose.
The first question everybody was like, nothing was in there, right? And we're like, no, thank God. We had loaded it all, because we were about to practice. So we had loaded into where we practice and stuff. And it was,
so what started the fire?
The fireman said that it was probably somebody flicked a cigarette from the alley. Because you can see, this is our alley, that's our garage, and it went on that parking lot right there. Yeah, and that garage had burned down too.
Oh, wow.
Because of it. That's all repaired and stuff.
A car inside of it that, like, a brand new Jeep that was toast. It was really intense.
It was a huge fire. Like, you know, he was saying I was standing far back from it with the hose. Like, I couldn't get any closer to the burning.
But it makes a great photo.
Yes, yeah, so we got a picture out of it. You know,
that was
$2,000
summer too, and it still sits in our backyard.
Oh, really? So it's part. It's an archive. This is an amazing archive piece. That
the landlord probably hates us, but it's okay.
This is JBTV. We're taking it to the House of Blues with Jarrod Gorbel, plus Cameron McGill and What Army perform live, and later 311. Keep it tuned right here.
What's up? We're under oath, and you're watching JibTiv.com.
JBTV!
Nice. What year is she?
I think it's like mid-70s, but I'm not 100% sure.
Like a Ford used to just come out with this, and then we moved to the jack here just to ground it.
Compared to like the other tours when you guys were touring with Margo, I knew that was actually quite a long list. You guys went all west and everything. What was that like? Were there any fun experiences with that?
Oh, I mean, I don't know. those guys are great. Like Richard's a sweetheart, you know. I think it was at the. Played that Lincoln Hall show, and I mean, he's a sweetheart, and he's been like a big vocal supporter and a big fan. And touring with those guys is a fun time, I think. I mean, I don't know.
That was a long one. I mean, we went through. I mean, that was good. We were with them for the month of October, and then Margo went back out in November. But it was great. We all traveled together.
Big bus full of sweaty dudes.
Yeah, I mean, it was
light bus.
Yeah,
school bus touring. It's like a re-outfitted school bus painted black. And I want to say short bus.
Hey, you can't leave them yellow. Did you know that?
Is that a law?
Yeah.
Like, you might get mistaken for
picked up and it's bad things. You have to change the color and remove off the door.
Speaking of shenanigans, I think one time we were in Minneapolis and we did actually try to pick some people up in the bus.
You know, that's called kidnapping.
Yeah, we didn't.
We were driving down the street and somebody was standing at a bus stop. And so we just pulled over and like
opened the door
and like she just
looks of terror.
The first time, second time she
in the vehicle. But there was like, you know, we paused for, you know, adequate amount of confusion to sort of like bubble up.
Yes, that would be
true. Just trust us.
A battle in a 5 o'clock rush. Oh, the smell of food is criminal in the traffic's blush. I walk by the feet of an ice open at night. spotlight. I took a punches on the crew.
The year is 1993. It's a JBTV show at Chicago's Metro with 311 and a lot more with Sons on JBTV next. JBTV!
Do you know whose gentleman to my right is, huh? Big hand for Mr. Jerry Bryant, huh? I'd like to thank JBTV along with Rose Records for doing a great job promoting this show. Capricorn recording artist 311.
It's what I want so much. I want nothing. Just this life and no more. I'll come with this one. There's only one for me. She's waiting. I'll soon come. I'm still in the sea. Swing the thing to bring, check it out. How can you be so good to me? How can you be so good to me? I want to be what? I want to be what? Buzz, buzz, yes, yeah, swing to the thing to bring, check it out. Like I said before, I say it once more. Do you want to make it feel so good? I want to be alive. Can't get enough, this is the stuff. Life's about an itch, just me. I'm gonna do you alive. We'll be right back.
guys, I'm Jenna Martinelli with JBTV on the scene, and right now I'm hanging out inside of the House of Blues. We are backstage in the dressing room with
Jarrod Gorbel, and we're recording live in the House of Blues.
And Jake Gorbel is your real name. It's not a...
No, no.
No stage name. I know, it sounds so... Right here, yeah.
It's really suave.
Jarrod Gorbel.
I mean, there's Gorbel, like the champagne.
Champagne. When this fails next week, I'll start work on the Champagne Gorbel line, cousin of Gorbel.
This is your first kind of solo debut from honorary title. So what was the change for you? What was the switch that brought you to be?
The honor title thing started out just as me solo, but I didn't want to come out as my name and kind of be grouped with like singer-songwriter boredom, you know, like adult contemporary. And now I've come full circle and I want to be part of that world after touring as the honorary title for a long time, which became a band. I just kind of was writing songs in the mindset of thinking that I was going to make a new honorary title record. What happened was I just decided that it would be a good excuse to kind of reinvent myself a little, and I also didn't, the band that I had toured with had changed up so much that I felt like for the recording I wanted to put a whole new band together, so it just seemed to make sense to start over in a way and just rename it Jarrod Gorbel.
Do you have other like side projects or anything that you work on besides your music?
Yeah, I like to make strange YouTube videos in my house by myself, dressing up as characters. I'm serious.
Are we allowed to air any of those? Because
I do have a bunch of YouTube videos up. That's what I do in my spare time, or I just loaf around.
Pretty cool.
I'm really lazy.
Very laid back and monotone, just a chill dude.
Super mellow.
Thanks for hanging out with us and giving us your time. That's it, guys. I'm Jenna Martinelli, JBTV on the scene. Jarrod Gorbel, awesome dude. Check out his videos and listen to his music.
This is Jarrod Gorbel, and you're watching JBTV.
This is JBTV. Cameron McGill and What Army are live in the studio, and later, a lot more with Sons.
We're Maps and Atlases.
And this is
JBTV.
JBTV!
Like, what's it like just touring with you guys? I mean, obviously you guys are pretty close together. You guys have been together for a long time.
I think any touring band like starts to develop their own language. And I like actually mean like words that sort of mean specific or non-specific things. And
sounds maybe.
You know, you start to, you know, you're English. Your mind starts to pancake, you know, between like driving between Illinois and Nebraska and Denver, you know, there's just a great expanse and your mind just flattens across, nothing makes sense, and you start to, I mean, I feel like one day we should like write down like this lexicon, because there's, you know.
People would be really interested in that.
Yeah. I mean, I think it'd be like a circle of 10 people.
We turn it into video blogs on tour, I think we leave it at that. And
touring is interesting because you're like, it's like a concentrated group and you're with each other 24/7 pretty much, but every day you're in a new place.
Thank you so much for being out here, man, coming out here. I've been, like, really, man, it was a pleasure, everyone. Once again, I'm Tanner Rittenhouse with Cameron McGill and What Army. Thanks a lot, guys.
I don't believe in magic, but all my friends just disappear. I guess they found that pot of gold. I figure they can buy new miners. I got no regret for Middle America, my middle finger. I got enough for you, my soft touch. Being poison is so finer. You start feeding your ego. That's when you start getting hungry. I've seen grown men cry. Lies as a smile, I'll pour your tea. Oh, no. When I say sunny day, in a dark ancient sound, I have time, baby, I ain't got time right now. Oh, no. I can't tongue and Mary's heart. At one for the money, two for the show, and three to get blown apart. You see, they got my collar, or the curb, it got my love. And people don't got my pressure points, you know I'm strong, they're pushing me so long. Just disappeared. I guess they found that pot of gold. I figured they could buy new miners.
TV limited edition stickers.
Wrong.
Can you take one?
Absolutely.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Awesome.
That way I can go on tour thank with you guys without going on tour.
Absolutely.
Spirit is with us.
We'll take them. Sure, thank you.
Cool.
Thank you.
Star case.
Yeah. Van if we owned one.
So you had fun?
Absolutely. Everybody was great. It was a lot of fun. Studio's beautiful.
Thank you.
Yeah.
It's built just for great talents like yourself.
It feels like it's like a rite of passage, you know, being in Chicago for so long and like, you know, when you're a kid is to show you that, you know, it all's here about.
Chicago's own Sons perform live right here at JBTV next. JBTV is brought to you in part by Rock Razor Scissors, Do312.com, and Emperor Cabs. JBTV!
Let's go.
Let's go get drunk, man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Did you have fun?
Yeah, it was great. It was awesome.
Awesome. You guys sounded great.
Thanks, man. Yeah, thanks for having us.
Yeah, thanks. Yeah. It's so great here.
Yeah, it's awesome having you guys here.
Tell us about the recording process when you first started recording this album and everything.
Well, when we sat Sons down...
Sons won.
we just kind of, you know, started writing all these songs, and then at some point we got scraped enough cash together to record them with our friend John Alvin, who's a producer. He's done a whole bunch of really cool stuff, like Dr. Manhattan. He did my old band, Wax and Radio, and stuff. And, you know, we started recording it in our basement and in his basement. And, you know, by the time that was done, we had worked up the material to do another EP by the time those four songs were done. So the guy who was mixing it was like, well, I'll track it for free. I got this place down on the south side, this rubber factory. It's a studio also.
Oh,
it's called...
Butcher Block. Well, it's called Butcher Block, and it's in a rubber factory.
Yeah, yes. It's pretty...
Do they make condoms?
Probably. It's pretty rustic. And so we set up in this huge, you know, open rubber factory, and we, you know, he was like, I'll do it, but we got to do it quick. So we set up in a room, like, you know, yeah, pretty yeah. big, and just recorded it live, just tracked. So Close Calls in the U.S. Space Program is done all live. Yeah, in two nights, yeah.
Wow. I think that's the way to do it, too.
And it was really bizarre. It's like in a full-blown factory setting. Like, there's stuff all over the walls, like, that could fall down because you're playing so loud. Yeah, like blades and, like, man, are they going to kill us or record us?
No injuries on the recording of the album?
No.
I don't think
we actually started at one point when we were tracking, because it's only five songs. It took us two nights and a full day. So at one point, we had been in there for a while, and we started getting the studio cabin fever, and Cody and I... put on, they made rubber boots and emergency vests and stuff. So we tracked, I think we tracked Little Horn in like emergency vests and big, huge fisherman boots and stuff.
Over your face, too, like a rubber mask or something.
So there you go, another great edition of JBTV, your alternative show from downtown Chicago. Hope you've enjoyed Sons performing live on our JBTV high definition soundstage. And I'm so happy that you guys have grown up pretty much watching JBTV over the years, because that is such an honor that now you are playing, and I can't wait to do a national tour. And also when you're on Jimmy Kimmel, Late Night with David Letterman. You will?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, actually, I can give you some JBTV stickers.
Oh, there's you. Look at that. That's awesome. Yeah, man.
There they go. So if you want a JBTV sticker, send me $100. Because only the bands get them for free. Well, stay tuned. A lot more music. This is JBTV from downtown Chicago.
Thank you.
Thanks.